Hey family, how y'all doing on this beautiful day? So I'm coming back with another video just to really explain another thing that I heard in the spirit that the Lord wants me to address. And it's something I heard that it was assumptions, but it was disgusting at the same time. So there's people that said, or someone in particular, I didn't ask because certain stuff I just don't care to know, but somebody said he's molesting her and she likes it. The Lord was like, blasphemy, foul, disgusting. What is wrong with people? Why would he do that? Another thing, people think that I still have some type of attraction to women. Blasphemy. Why would Jesus even want to entertain himself with somebody that's attracted to women or anybody in general? Y'all gotta understand that if he chose somebody to be a bride, there's a reason for it, and there's a loyalty that's attached to that, and there's a purity that's attached to that as well. It's deeper than just him choosing a virgin. It's way deeper. He's Jesus. He has high expectations. There's no way he's gonna allow somebody to be his bride and be moving a certain way or thinking a certain way. No, false. I heard people in the spirit saying they're sexualizing her. That's wrong, and it is, and there's a price they gotta pay for that. That's weird. They're sexualizing, and that's what they said. She's a human, which, hello, like, they're turning it into some type of fantasy, and it's just weird to me. Like, it's just, imagine I'm at a pulpit and there's a church full of people and I'm preaching the word of God, because this is what's happening in the spirit. So I'm just bringing it to the natural and making sense of how disgusting and evil and perverted that is. And I'm at the pulpit, and these people, instead of paying attention to what's coming out of my mouth and what I'm saying, they're in, you know, they're sitting down and they're fornicating with themselves. That's what it looks like to God. So y'all put two and two together. Like, that's beyond weird to me. I'm not even saying anything or doing anything that's sexual. And that's another thing. Somebody said, I heard them in the spirit say this, blasphemy, because it's the Holy Spirit, which has perfected me. So somebody said the way I'm moving my videos is on purpose to seduce or something like that, to be sexual. That is foul. That's foul. Absolutely not. It's the spirit. It's spiritual. Everything's spiritual. Just like, that's another thing I should just address right here while I'm at it. Because, you know, everybody just assumes so because they don't know nothing. They don't know nothing. So, people at my last job, right? They was like, she's fake, right? She's fake because she acts different at work than she does on camera. Let me tell you something. I had to put the notebook down for that. Let me tell you something. It's spiritual. Everything is spiritual. The way I interact with different people are different. It's spiritual. There's a reason behind that. There's a reason behind it, behind everything, because the spirit knows everything. So it's just so crazy how powerful his spirit is, right? Because there's people that call themselves Christians, but they don't have the Holy Spirit, so they don't do this, but I do this, and I'm explaining what I do. So, say for example, I'm talking face to face with a pedophile, and see the things that come to my mind automatically because of how perverted people are. But say I'm talking to a pedophile, right? I'm not going to interact with him the same way I would just someone who, I don't know, I'm gonna just say a child of God, because the spirit knows who that person is. It's not me. I don't know this person, but for some reason, I'm not excited to talk to this person. For some reason, I don't care to know more about whatever this person has to say. And whatever they say, it's like, it sounds like noise in my ear. But then when I talk to a child of God, it's just all, you know, excitement and joyful and loving and just, you know, an outpouring of happiness. I don't know, but the spirit knows everything. And so when I was at work, let me tell you something, I felt the darkness, I felt the demons. So I'm in spiritual warfare, little do you know. So while you think I'm just sitting here being stank or what was they saying, depressed, no, I just know that, like, it's like, y'all, the demons at that one particular job that I literally just left, so powerful, so powerful, but in a dark way. Like, I felt it, like, as soon as I stepped foot in, it was really the break room that I felt it so forth, like, it was like a force. It's like I don't even know how to explain. It's like you're walking through thick darkness, but you don't see it, but you feel it. So yeah, I'm just literally like taking all of that in. Like, I'm very sensitive to the spirit. So yeah, if you talk to me and I can sense, and not even me, my spirit can sense that either one, you've been talking about me behind my back, or two, you're just dark, period. My spirit senses that. So I'ma just literally talk to you like this. Yeah, uh-huh. Yeah. Yep. That's yep. Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah. I ain't gonna be rude or disrespectful. I'm just not interested for some reason. But then when I talk to somebody else, I actually want to get to know you. Okay, so where are you from? This and that. Oh yeah, wow, really? And it's funny because when that first started happening to me, I was like, why do I do that? Like, why? I was questioning myself. I'm like, I talked to this person like this, but I talked to this person like that. It's the spirit. So no, I'm not going to talk a certain way. And especially knowing, like, if I was talking to a pedophile and my spirit knows what would get them off, so to speak, it's going to not do that, even if that's a part of my personality on purpose, because you're not going to get something out of whatever you think you're going to get out of the conversation or whatever it may be. No, absolutely not. So this is deeper, like, it's so much deeper than people understand. Like, my spirit picks up on so much that I interact with people different, and it's not that I'm judging, but it's the spirit, period. Just like my son, the man child, when I told y'all the dream I had where people would come and try to interact with him, and it was my earthly aunt that tried to, and he mean mugged her. He didn't care to listen. This is all the spirit. He was mugging her. He didn't laugh, smile, none of that, straight face, because he sensed the demons. So if I sense demons, I'm gonna be uncomfortable. That's just it. I'm gonna be very uncomfortable, and you're gonna see it, you're gonna hear it. It's just that. That's just what it is. That's just what it is. And then I realized when I put on, yo, it's like my spirit imitates what they're doing so that I know their spirit, what their spirit's doing. So it's not even that I'm being fake, but like, it's the spirit letting me know this person's faking the smile. So if I have a real smile when I'm talking to you, it's like, okay, this person's real. This person really means what they say. But if I'm like, that's the Lord telling me in my spirit, that person's smile is fake. Matter of fact, this is a witch, and that's why her smile is so big, because she's pretending. So y'all, this is so deep. The spirit is so deep, and I just had to address that as well, because people think, oh, she's, no. Because the way I act on camera is gonna be the way I act in front of those who can appreciate the spirit, because that's all that I talk about. All I talk about is spirit. What do you want me to do? Fake talk about stuff that I don't care about? Because the world is different from the spirit. So the world cares about one thing and the spirit cares about another thing. I can't fake that. So I'm gonna just not talk if we're in the same vicinity. I mean, you ask me a question, I'll give you an answer. You say whatever it is, but can we have a long, deep conversation? No, because we have two different perspectives on life completely. So that's what that is. So no, I'm not fake. That's just the truth of it. The spirit can sense what you are, what demon is inside of you, where they came from, and wants no parts. So that's what that is. discernment. Get you some discernment, and you won't be talking to that guy that keeps cheating on you and tells you I'll do better, or beats on you and tells you he's gonna stop. Because no, they have a demon in them. You know what? Thank you, Lord. He just reminded me something. So yeah, absolutely not. Absolutely not. And when I do that face, because that's another assumption. People are saying that I'm smiling and that's sick, or I'm laughing and that's sick. That face that I made, and I'm gonna put another picture of when I made that face, y'all, that is not a smile. That is a like, yeah, gotcha. You thought you had one up and you don't. That's what that face is. And I'm gonna put the emoji that it looks like to me. This is a smile. This, who smiles like that? That's a problem if you think that's a smile. But anyway, y'all have a blessed, beautiful, wonderful, not assuming day. Lord, y'all, the stuff people be thinking, you know what's crazy? When I was younger, people would be like, oh, like what superpowers do you wish you had? I remember saying, I wish I could read people's mind. I'll take that back. I'll take it back. I don't care what you think anymore. Like, I take that back. Because knowing what people think is like, oh my. Make it stop. Make it stop. Be careful what you wish for. Be careful what you pray for. But y'all have a beautiful, blessed day in Jesus' mighty, precious, holy name.